permission also to add into this. So in a day, you know, we have to drink minimum 2.5 liters of water, and make sure you drink more water before 6 p.m. So that is very good for health. And with this, you know, we'll conclude and let's move on to the session, which is table topic. So to conduct this session, okay, we have a very positive and active person, and last week he has got the best TT award outside PTC is our purpose of the day, Manjara Tamaswa.
Good afternoon, fellow Toastmasters and esteemed guests. For the benefit of the guests, I'll explain briefly about this table topic session. This is an extempore speaking session wherein you will be asked to come over here and speak for 1 to 2 minutes. The idea is to speak on your feet and think on your feet. And this also helps you in real time when you're working and in your real time environment. And please make sure that you don't speak less than 1 minute and not more than 2 minutes and 30 seconds, because else it will be disqualified. So just limit your time between 1 to 2 minutes. And I would also encourage everyone to use the word of the day today, which is Ryan. And let's get started now. So initially I would ask any one Toastmaster to come and pick the sheet so that the guest will have an idea of how the session moves on. And maybe later on you can ask the guest to pick up the sheets. I would request anyone to come and pick a topic. Or do you want me to choose anyone? Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
In today's world, we have forgotten the meaning of patience. Many of us read articles, magazine, newspaper, books, anything. We all do that, right? What was the last time any one of us read something in detail? I used to be an avid reader. I remember that back in 2007, I think, I went on a reading spree. Sidney Sheldon, at that time, that just caught hold of me. I mean, I used to love those stories. And I remember that I must have read like 7 or 8 books from the same guy in a span of 3 months. But today, as my life progressed, I moved on to my graduation years. It felt like I lost all my patience. Nowadays, I don't find time enough to read a book, let alone a book. I cannot read a whole newspaper article. All I do is I just glance over it and just try to get a gist out of it. And this is just one of the things which reminds me that we have truly forgotten the meaning of patience. It's always better to take a moment. Take a moment to live in it. And by this example, I just want to put a point that take your time with something. And it's always better that way. Thank you.
Thanks, Siddharth. That was nice. And I would request anyone else to continue next week. Or do you want me to select? Yeah, sure, please.
It was 6 a.m. in the morning when we had all gone for a village camp. It was not during the school days because back then I didn't even know what was yoga. So coming back to my college days, it was 6 a.m. in the morning and the whistle blew. It was the camp master. He kept a huge speaker in front of the room to wake us all up and played Lungi dance. He felt the essence of yoga then. When we all tried to wake up from the bed and come out, he said, "Go change your night dresses into yoga pants and come back." that was the most creepiest moment any student can feel, waking up at 6 a.m. in the morning to do yoga. We all assembled and gathered in one place, sat together, and he began for music. The music that engrossed all of us together to do yoga. But that practice was done after the 5 days of camping. After that, none of us did yoga. But today, the essence of yoga is preached. Even our Prime Minister tells us how important it is to do yoga. He sits amidst the hall of 1,000 people and does yoga. Today, even schools, as a part of National Yoga Day, have taken that small step to enable students to do yoga and grow up to be citizens who can think better than what we've taught. If that little practice was there for all of us here, we would have had patience. So let us ensure that we go back to those kids who are doing yoga as a part of their curriculum, learn a little bit from them, and be patient. And be as patient as they are.
Please, I would invite the guests to come take a topic.
Healthy body, healthy mind, positive life. So, most of us would have come across this proverb, right? As a sound mind resides in a sound body, healthy mind resides in a healthy body. I can vouch for this because I've been playing badminton for the past 3 months now. And there is a remarkable improvement in the way I think the whole day progresses and the pace at which I do my work. Earlier, it was most of the days would be like it will just be gradually progressing without much of the work being done. Today, I'm much more productive thanks to being a badminton player for the past 3 months. You can take up any other activity, not just badminton, be it yoga or gym or any other physical activity that will make you feel better. So I certainly do think that a sound, a healthy mind, a healthy body makes a positive impact on all of us. Yeah. Thank you.
Technology eating into our family time. Amma, where is my phone? The first thing we all ask when we get up. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Technology has certainly consumed all our time. The first thing we see, before 20 years back, the first thing our parents saw was their lucky charm. So for my grandmother, it was my Chittapasa. My father's younger brother was my grandmother's lucky charm. So the first thing she does is see my father's younger brother. But today, the first thing we see is, who has sent me how many WhatsApp? Has the boy I replied yesterday sent me a reply back? No, I'm heartbroken. So every day in the morning when we wake up, we expect for something. Which is, we all of us, dinner table, every time I come and sit in the dinner table, I'm fiddling on the phone, my brother's fiddling on the iPad, my father's fiddling on something, and then there is my mother waiting for like, do I serve you this, do I serve you that? And then we are all very technology driven. We all are so many opinions. Every day on Facebook you share so many opinions. But do you really sit and talk to your family? You talk, you discuss so many things in Facebook in a social arena, but where is the only thing you need is to discuss with your family. That's where the root lies. So a tree will bloom only when the roots are strong. So your root is the family. So like how much friends you have doesn't really matter. The quantity doesn't matter. The quality matters. You can have 1,000 friends in Facebook, but you can be the loneliest person in reality. Whereas you can not have any friends in Facebook and have 4 friends in real life and be the most happiest person. So 24 hours, so I'm going to give you a task. 24 hours, go without Facebook, go without your phones. You'll be the happiest man on earth. Trust me.
Modern people enjoy a better lifestyle than people in the past day? No. Answer is straight away no. We are lucky enough to born and brought up in a village culture. Okay, we never seen a phone when still I enter my degree. So we used to gather with a couple of kids and we used to enjoy with the the local games what we had. You might have never heard, okay, those games that we call Jibli. And to climb a tree, fall down, my right arm got broken 2 times for that. Okay, we enjoyed our life like that, okay. Now, the last week I went to my native again. Even I can see some kids, even from my Chikama, so that kid, everyone are busy in phone. They got Clash of Clans, even I got my Clash of Clans. They are my leaders, okay. I am an elder and they are the leaders and they are saying you should attack to the other troop over there. You never go to play or you won't play cricket or something? No, they said no. What is that one? We don't want to go there. We just, we're happy and my mom scolds me if I go out. His mom scolds him if he goes out. My mom used to scold me if I am in home. That was the life he did and it was so good that the most of the remembers what we have, so most of the memories we have, so all the sweet memories I have. So I'm just worried what the people are getting now, what the kids are getting now, and what the people are leaving right now. So the answer was no.